Durant to Green. For Durant, down low. Tough-looking shot there. Still gets it to go down.
He's a modern-day big that plays like a 6'2 guard. Scale.
Here comes the screen. Temple. Green always looking for the steal.
That make 5 out of 10 shots in practice, but then all of a sudden they're not gamers because then they're making 1 of 10. That's exactly what you want him to do. You want him to take those kind of shots.
Jay, I don't know if you call that the shooter's touch, but they will take it.
Well, essentially the touch did help the ball go in, and I don't know, I might have to agree to disagree on that.
Alexander. Oh, bad pass there. Warriors have it. Gets it to go. A lot of contact, but no foul. Have we ever seen anyone like KD?
Easy answer. No, he's the greatest offensive threat we've ever seen in the game. He has a 7'5 wingspan, and he's doing things that Russell Westbrook does with the ball. We've never seen him.
Shai-Gilgeous-Alexander. Down to 5 on the 24. Has a look. Gets a shot up. Off the mark.
Ooh, I like that intensity on that play. That's how you actually dig in the dirt and do your job on a defensive end.
Ah, Steph Curry. 3 for 3. That's a perfect start. His instincts are unnatural, but what makes him so good given the work he's put in?
The special thing about Stephen Curry is that his entire life he has practiced great habits. A lot of players practice and get up shots, but they don't practice the right habits, and that comes with the lineage. His father, Dale Curry, making sure that he puts in time and effort with the proper skill with the time and effort.
Has a chance, shot no good there by Gallinari. Durant, deep left corner. To Durant. Yes, and the foul. And a chance at 3 coming up.
The defender was actually in a good position there. He even made a decent play on the ball. But sometimes those bounces go the other way. Still, stay aggressive out there.
Beverly to Williams.
You're moving the ball, you're capitalizing on mistakes, and you really build a nice lead.
Shai-Gilgeous-Alexander at the line. No
defensive play there, but you can't fault the defender for being up in the shooter. You need to contest shots, each and every one of them.
Danilo Gallinari at the line for two shots. A career 86% for the line. And he connects on the first free throw. Gets it in the left corner. Deshaun Livingston. Thompson. Down low Durant. And the finish. Slam dunk.
I don't know if the scouting report has made its way out here again, but if anything, it says you need to not let him get that close to the rim. Durant to Green. Going to launch beyond the arc, and the Clippers able to clear the board. And you move on. You did exactly what the game plan was defensively to guard a player like that.
Thompson to Curry. Doesn't get the bounce.
Alexander. Thompson. The jumper's off the mark.
And this is where you know you have the
it's right where you want them. Every possession, all you see them doing is complaining to the ref, complaining to each other. You're making the game uncomfortable. That's the bottom of good defense.
And that'll get out of bounds. Last touch by the Clippers. Looks like both teams are making substitutions. Golden State at the controls. Thompson to Durant. Five to shoot for Golden State. Thompson to Durant. Let's it fly for long range. Smothering D. Has a chance. Gets a look. Can't hit.
It's easy. Force guys into low percentage shots. That's the reason why we're big into stats. It was all provided to you before the game was started.
8 seconds. It's going the other way. Shifting gears. Here comes some substitutions. Temple takes aim at Livingston. To Gilgeous-Alexander. The screen sets him up for two.
Oh, don't see the read, be the read.
Warriors basketball. Baseline drive. Short jumper off the mark.
Here's the beautiful thing about having a bad game. As long as it says W in the win column after the game is over, then nothing else really matters. You've done your job.
Oh, the touch at the rim. Count it.
I wasn't necessarily sure which way that PNR was going. But I guess neither was the defense. That makes two of us.
Livingston across the timeline. Up six. To Green.
And that's next level defense. The defender took away the pocket space of the shooter. Now, as a shooter, they shoot hundreds of shots each and every day from that pocket with consistency. Now you're forcing them to change the angle or the position of that pocket, you're going to lower the chances of them making that shot.
To Gilgeous-Alexander. Lets it fly from beyond the arc. Now that's a good test.
And look, sometimes you don't have it going every single night. Maybe utilize yourself as a decoy and get some teammates involved with your passing.
Timeout called here by the Clippers. But this game's in the balance, and time is of the essence. Coach is going to shift gears and adjust his matchups. To Gilgeous-Alexander. Trying to cash in, and the Warriors have the rebound. Iguodala to bring it up, up by six. Here comes the intentional foul, but they did have one to give, so no free throws yet. They'll shoot after the next foul.
Smart play. You have fouls to use. Good way to manage the clock without burning the timeout.
And here's the foul. Right now it's a two-possession game, so if he hits one or two of these, that could be all she wrote.
Okay, now look over to the sideline and see what the staff is trying to draw up on the next play. It's good clock management thus far. Will cause a little havoc. As designed, the team that uses it to gout